And I welcome to all of you here to our this online literary program called Sages of Sin. This program is a project of Readers Academy of English Language and English Literature, Larkham. My name is Munir Domki. I teach literature to postgraduate class students. And I would like to also tell you that we have also got a very beautiful name of this program in our native language. We call it Mudat Anokhi Adiyan. Well, I would like to tell you that today it is our fourth program on a Sindhi literary giant, and the poet that we have chosen today to spend some time to talk about him and his literary contribution in literary work is Fayaz Baloch. Fayaz Baloch is the pen name of Fayaz Chandio Baloch, who hails from a small town, Kherpur Nathan Shah, of District Dadu of Sindh. It is much known about this man, whose picture is behind me, that he enjoys good reputation among literary circles of his town and district because of his humbleness, polite manners, polite behavior, and humble nature. Fayaz Baloch, contributed sometimes articles and essays in various periodicals of national and international repute, and he has also tried his pen in writing and penning down short stories too. And recently, he has got his first collection of short stories published and named it Duhan Til Shah. The layout of that book is behind me too. If we have the rough translation of this work in English, we may call it is City Filled with Smoke. There is another book too, to his credit, and that book is called, which is in my hand too, Kair Jobhan Ke Sambhale. The rough translation of this work in English would be How to Control Young Age. And this is his collection of ghazals, his collection of poems. Fayaz Baloch, tried his pen in both these three, genres of literature. He has proved himself a good story writer too, a good prose writer too. But poetry is very close to his heart, to his soul. The reason why, because that he had been composing, he had been composing poetry when hardly a patch of hair had grown on his upper lip. So one could imagine the kind of the love that he displays to poetry too. Today, since this lecture would be dedicated to him and we will be talking about his ghazals, his poetry too, and especially this book that is in my hand, Kair Jobhan Ke Sambhale. Now look, the novelty of this name, Kair Jobhan Ke Sambhale, How to Control Young Age. And this Fayaz Baloch, who after retiring as a teacher educator in 18th grade recently, at the age of 60, he produced almost two works. Now, this speaks volumes about the novelty of this man. What young people cannot do, this man has done. Now, generally it happens that in Western countries or in Western societies that people after retirement, they get themselves involved in various projects and various schemes. And this seems to be something annual, thing for this part of the world, that a man, nearing 60 years old, and he ends up producing two great works. One, a collection of short stories, the other, a collection of ghazals. And that too, when he is 60 years old. Well, good thing about this poet that I personally found in this work, the silent characteristics of his poetry are that he talks about modernism and postmodernism in his poetry. He has also given a unique notion of poetry in this book, collection of ghazals. He also talks about, he talks extensively about the social issues too, and love, beauty, romanticism, nationalism, or the very themes or topics which are very near to him. Now, let me tell you more about him, that what is, you know, his diction, what kind of a diction that he uses in this collection of ghazals. He profusely uses similes and metaphors and literaries in his work. More importantly, he has got another technique which is rare among his contemporary poets, that he has got a gift of repetition of his thoughts in his, you know, poems in a way that at the very time they do not look to be you know, boring. They look to be very you know, appealing in nature. So he uses anaphora too, a literary poetic device, in his this collection of poetry. Well, all of us know that whenever a poet has to produce the work, a collection of poetry, a collection of the poems, that he must come with a novel, you know, idea about the poetry too. That what is he gonna present in his work? What do we come to know about this poet, Fayaz Baloch, that he has given a unique notion of poetry in his collection of ghazals. Now, what is his notion of poetry in his collection of ghazals in this work? That he says that shari waqt thi ghure saain, dil lagi waqt thi ghure saain. Now, according to him, that love and poetry are serious business. They are time-taking duties. In order to master the poetry, one has to allocate the time to it. And in order to develop more understanding in love matters or love affairs, the lover and the beloved both have to give time to it. Means love and poetry are time-taking business. They are time-taking duties. And without giving proper time to them, one cannot nurture them, one cannot nourish them or help them grow. Apart from this, Fayaz Baloch also says, and he avers another fact that needs to be shared and understood too. He says that gal dilji sidhi karan Fayaz shayariya mein karan manavai. Now, this idea may not be applicable to the Western societies, that because Western societies are open societies and they are much liberal societies, where a poet or a lover has to express his love feelings, you know, openly. But here, in this part of the world where we live, it almost becomes a hard nut to crack for a poet to express his love, passionate feelings for his mistress. Therefore, Fayaz Baloch says that to speak heart's desire, to speak heart's feelings straight in the poetry is forbidden. Well, apart from this, we come to know that Fayaz Baloch has a seminal knowledge about modernism and postmodernism. And time and again, we do see the reflection of modernism and postmodernism in his poetry too, as he says that samura mujhe sharin falsafa tha. Now, all philosophies today, they perturb and disturb the main today, that one does not know that which philosophy to follow. So that's why the poet says that samura mujhe sharin falsafa tha, zamane mein sochan jo kehram aaye. Now, there are many thoughts, many words, and many confusions. Which one to follow? Well, now, these lines especially are very touchy when Fayaz Baloch says that dosti dushmani halam gad gad, khil khushi e gam halam gad gad, mohate goda gila the thi parput, bandagi gandagi Alan Gutko. Now, in these lines, what we come to know that this man has written these two works in his in his age when around at 60. So one can imagine the kind of the experience that he might have gone through in his life. So the poet is talking about that friendship and rivalry go together. Joy and sorrow go together. And we see the people today in our part of the world, in our society, that they weep, they cry, but behind the person, they backbite too. And what does the very concept of worship remain if people are involved in indulge in vices too? So this is what he comes with, a pragmatic approach. He has got a pragmatic approach to life too. And his modernism and postmodernism reflect that too. Well, moreover, what do we come to know in this poet, Fayaz Baloch, that his poetry is full of wit, full of pragmatic thoughts, and pregnant thoughts. Now, as he says that, Dard Bhogan Mazak to Samjhi, In Ye Sochan Mazak to Samjhi, Tha Haki Roop Sivajan Nakuli, Roop Matajan Mazak to Samjhi, Mukhate Murku Ali Sajaye Tho, Gam Me Murkan Mazak to Samjhi. The poet is asking, addressing to his beloved, addressing to readers, saying that, is it a joke to suffer audience? Is it a joke to think like that? That thinking and suffering are two separate things. Those who cause suffering, they are happy. But the poet suffered from the audience, from the pain, asking his mistress that, is it a joke for you? Is it a light thing? Dard Bhogan Mazak to Samjhi, In Ye Sochan Mazak to Samjhi, and you think it in a light manner. Tha Haki Roop Thivan Nakuli, Roop Matajan Mazak to Samjhi. Shakespeare almost, speaks a similar kind of, expresses a similar kind of thought in his play Hamlet, in Act 3, Scene 1, when Hamlet was talking to, or when Hamlet talks to Ophelia, saying that God has given you one face and you make yourself another. The same thing this poet is talking here in these lines, that Tha Haki Roop Thivajan Nakuli, when the real face is real, something an artificial look, or they pretend to be unreal. Roop Matajan Mazak to Samjhi, is it a joke? If the duality of somebody is exposed, beloved or someone else, is it a joke? No more a joke. For people like you and me, sitting here and talking about these lines, this may look a non-serious thing, but for a person suffering from the pangs of love, this is no more a joke. That's why the poet gets hurt when the duality of his beloved is exposed to him. Tha ki roop thivajan nakuli, roop matajan mazak to samjhi. Is it a joke? Another thing, Fayaz Baloch speaks in his this book, Kher Joban Ke Sambhale, a collection of ghazals, that Hosh behosh thi gam mein, akulat naaz ki na keh paunche. Now, here he talks about the psychological truth about the most exalted creature of God, man. That when a man suffers too much in his life, then he forgets to use his reasoning power in a proper way. Man claims to be an exalted creature, but very soon he falls prey to sheer frustration. And remember, Frustrated man is not a thinking man. That's why this poet says that Hosh behosh thi gam mein, akulate naaz ki na keh paate. When your reasoning power does not work in a critical situation, then why to be proud of such reasoning power? Well, another distinguished quality of this Sindhi poet that I personally have found after rifling through and reading this book, that another essential quality of this poet is that, he composes lines or poetry on the real incidents too, and the recent incidents too. This is, a distinguished quality of this man whose picture is behind me, as he says that, Road rasta blak thi vya hai, keen khulya tilak thi vya hai, shahar mein ko mato mamman hai, phone number jo lock thi vya hai. Now, if the roads are blocked, and it took several hours to get them opened, and if your cell phones are even not working and they have been technically disconnected, and you are cut off from your loved ones and relatives, then this poet is basically also questioning the validity of the very welfare state too. Road rasta block thi gaya hai, ki na khulya tilak thi gaya hai, shahar mein ko mato maman aaye, phone number jo lock thi gaya hai. Apart from this, Fayaz Baloch also composes satirical poet too, though technically his satire is not perfect, but he does compose a satirical poetry too, mocking and criticizing the politician recently a politician has given a very abusive remark about the public selectivity of vote, as he says that here, even in his couplet, Fayaz Baloch says that such politicians do not deserve to be called as politicians, or they do not deserve to be called the welfare of public. Well, we also find another thing in his poetry, Fayaz Baloch's poetry, that he composes poetry on familiar, renowned, personalities too, paying rich tribute, glowing tribute to the former female prime minister of Pakistan, who was assassinated a decade ago in Rawalpindi, Benazir Bhutto. He pays a rich tribute to her, saying that December achi fat khole tho, December achi fat khole tho, dilu aahin ranjoor aya, tote salam shaheed jamhuriyat, aam na mili jamhoor aya, tunjo qatil mafroor aya, diho diha magroor aya. Paying a rich tribute to former Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto, the poet is saying that when the December comes, it really hurts, because December was the very month in which the former Prime Minister of Pakistan, Benazir Bhutto, was assassinated, 27th December 2007, sorry, let me correct, 2007, and is saying that the fruits of democracy have not reached to the people as yet after her death, and her murderers, the people who have murdered her, who have assassinated her, they are priests and they walk unpunished. And this is why His heart is very panic stricken. The poet's heart is very sorrowful. Well, Fayaz Baloch, apart from all these distinguished qualities of his poetry, he also talks about romanticism. Since Ghazal itself is a poem that talks about the beauty, about the rosy cheeks, about the beautiful figure of the beloved. So, as a poet, he has emerged as a romantic poet too in his collection of Ghazal. As he says that, Gulaban ja disi, gul yaad aya, avan ja khubsurat gal sajaya. Now, poet, after watching roses, remember the rosy cheeks of his mistress. Another thing that we notice in his poetry is that the personal agony the poet goes through, and he does express that personal pain, the pain of loneliness, the pain of separation from his beloved, and this is also reflected in his poetry too, where he says that ladi aayo na dil dekho musafir reha veeran dil ja sabhi khazan. So his heart is empty because no traveler, nobody has come, no beloved, no one has come to him to father his lonely name. Vichhodan de raatan mein fayaz kati hai jaagi jawani. The poet is, this is what he talks about, his inner pain, that when he got the separation, pain of separation of his mistress, he has spent his entire young age by, waking at night. Well, the most important thing, to be very honest, viewers, that I tell you that I have found in this book, Kher Jobhan Ke Sambhale, is that his poetry is pragmatic too. His approach to life is very pragmatic. And this has appealed me a lot, that how this man in this age, 60 years old he is, and after his retirement, he talks about all his personal experiences too. As he says that, aao ta gaddi kitab ke samjho, zindagi de nisab ke samjho. Now, poet is asking the reader, let us learn, let us understand the very book of life, the very syllabus of the life. And now, what is the syllabus of the life? The poet is talking in the next line. Pyar tahmul sikho wadi agte, deeh roshan je taap ke samjho. The poet is telling the syllabus of life is tolerance, love and let others love. Tolerate and teach this tolerance to others too, that those who are practical in life, they know that life is full of pain. They know that life is full of puzzling questions. They know that life is full of complexity. Life is full of questions whose answers men even do not have. Now, what is then the best way to deal life? To tolerate the suffering, to tolerate the pains of life. Aao tagar ji kitab ke samjho, zindagi je nisab ke samjho. Pyar tahmal sikho wadi agte. Now, this is the best way. In order to push life, you need to tolerate everything, and you need to love and let others love you. And deeh roshan je taap ke samjho. Kiye zamano kadhe tarah tho pyo pechi jate hain saaf ke samjho. The world is a puzzling one. We live in a puzzling world, and this puzzling world has become more puzzling after the World War I, where the humanity of the modern people is questioned too. And that's why the poet is saying that he uses the modernist element in his poetry too. Kiye zamano kadhe tarah tho pyo the entire society is now making men, you know, more puzzling. पेचीदा अपने हिसाब के समझ लेट अंडरस्टैंड द वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सोसाइटी एंड द कॉम्प्लेक्स बिहेवियर्स ऑफ पीपल देन वाई डू दे बिहेव इन सच अ पर्टिकुलर वे वेल इन दिस बुक आई ऑल्सो फाउंड द अदर वेरी अपीलिंग थिंग इज द मैसेज ऑफ लव दैट ही गिव सिंस इज अ रोमेंटिक पोएट सो लव इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग that is very near to his heart and how it is possible or how a romantic poet or a person if he writes poem and does not talk about the love it is impossible Fayaz Baloch also talks about the love and love feelings too now according to him that this is the supreme quality of love that love makes man a man Now, if there are no love feelings in man's life, his life is, you know, an animal's life. As he says that, ishq insaan to banaye hai, pyar dharmaan to banaye hai. So this is the power of the love that love makes man a man, and love is the panacea of all ills. Moreover, he is also talking about another fact about the traditional view of the love too in his poetry. That akul kamzor ishq jado, ishq mastaan to banaya. Akul kamzor ishq jado, ishq mastaan to banaya. According to the poet that those who love do not reason out. And that's why man goes crazy in love. Now this is a traditional view he has portrayed in his poetry too. This poet also explores the nature of the love too. On the one hand, he talks about the love that love is a great asset in the man's life because man has no identity outside the love feeling. He is no more a man himself. He explores the nature of the love, saying that. इश्क जो राज की न कह पातो राज न्याज की न कह पातो चार पल प्यार जा गनीमत पर प्यार आवाज की न कह पातो नाउ सीक्रेट ऑफ लव हैज स्टिल रिमेन द सीक्रेट दो मैन लिव्स इन द 21st सेंचुरी एंड येट ही कुड नॉट अंडरस्टैंड Why do people love? Why do they fall in love? And why do people not understand this fact that why love has become a necessary thing, a necessity in man's life? Can man not live without love? And the answer of this question may be the very thing that ishq insaan to banaye hai, pyar dharmaan to banaye hai. Men cannot live without love because love makes men a man. And man, it is the feeling of love that distinguishes man from other creatures of God. He also talks about the same satiety of love in his poetry too. As he says that, Nathi lahe pyaar ji unyaya. Pyaas rahu kabhi lahe. The poet talks about the fair satiety of love. That the more he loves, the better he feels that his love is still lacking something. Well, we also find a very important thing in his poetry is that though he's a romantic poet, but yet he gives the concept of life too in his poetry. Since I told you that he has seen many highs and lows of life and he has jotted down those experiences in his poetry too. So this is a man whose picture is behind me. He has seen life from very close quarters and portrayed the life too in his poetry, as he says that now this is a very zindagi jo musafaton dukhyo bar nikran mazak to samjhi. Now the journey of life is not so simple as people generally assume about it or think about it. And is it a joke to, you know, come out from those troubles or difficulties of life? Because life road is bumpy, and man as a traveler has to take care a lot to come out from those all bumps, those all thorns that come in his way. And it's no more a joke. Why it's no more a joke? Because one has to be very serious to come out from the complexities and troubles of life, from those bumpy roads. Zindagi jo musafaton dukhyo par nikran mazak to samjhi. Is it a joke? And he also talks about the mortality of life too. Because since he is a romantic poet, and romantic poets remain much gloomy about mortality, as he says that gulatadi kumajan tha zindagi thi mein nazar mein, as flowers bloom and wither, life is like that, the poet is saying. So this was what our brief lecture on Fayaz Baloch, a senior poet hailing from Kherpur Nathan Shah of Dadu district of Sindh. Viewers, my name is Munir Domki and you are watching the online program Sages of Sindh. And this program is a project of Readers Academy of English Language and English Literature behind Girls Degree College near Sagar Book Store, GP Road, Larkana. So with this we sign up. We will meet another with another poet, another lecture next time. Till then, Khuda Hafiz.